reforms. We've tried to implement electoral reform many times in the past, most recently in Ontario with the referendum over the mixed member proportional system. How can we be reassured that electoral reform, once implemented, will actually stick?
So the Liberals are committed to ensuring that 2015 is the last federal election conducted under the first-past-the-post voting system. And how we will ensure or encourage us to be successful this time around is that we are committed to introducing legislation 18 months after being elected. And that legislation will be introduced because Canadians will be engaged in that process. So when we are committed to the process and we are part of that fabric, we will be empowered to encourage other people to support the process. We'll be able to provide the resources and information needed so that they are committed to passing and are supportive of the process that we are pushing forward. So we are not committed to any one process. We are committed to representing Canadians across this nation. That's why I'm happy that the room is full of people that are willing to engage. So rather than determining for you the best method, I think it's important that we have citizens' engagement. Something that we learned from Ontario is that people do need to be involved and engaged. And learning from the past strengthens the future. So that's why we are committed to going back to the roots, going back to Canadians, and not telling you how to get things done, but us together making it right. So thank you.
Supposing your party is turns out to be a laggard on this issue, I'm wondering about your personal commitment to this, what you would do, and would you work on this? Would you work with other parties that in the House that are interested in this? Would you work with other individuals to make something happen?
So I'm born and raised in this community, so I know that Waterloo is not only amazing, we are capable of greater. And if you know my history in the Liberal Party, you'll recognize that I too have learned from those around me. And that's the beauty of democracy, is having an opinion. And if you can back your opinion, that's great. But if you can listen to other people and come to consensus, I think we're even greater. And that's something I'm proud of the Liberal Party and Justin Trudeau's leadership has committed to actually representing and working across party lines. Partisan politics is at an all-time high, and that's partly why I'm in this race. We have to represent the constituents of this riding, not be toying our party line, and that is a commitment that I will make to every single person in this room and every single person in this riding. People who have worked with me know me very well. I have a strong opinion, and I will battle it. But I will also battle to the death the right for any individual to also have their own opinion. And that's why I think it's important that we engage an all-party committee, engage citizens and experts to the table so that we make the right decision. And I think that is how the electoral reform process will be the strongest and at its best. So I look forward to working with any and everyone that chooses to, and anybody who doesn't, I will encourage you to, because I do tend to have that kind of influence. So I understand that Fair Vote is trying to promote a process that all parties, citizens, and experts are there to design a Made in Canada process, which I am supporting. And I think we need to have the debate and discussion at the table so that any concerns can be raised. Each system will have its strengths and its weaknesses, but we want to make sure that we make the best decision for Canadians. And that's why the engagement process is important. This is it's an opportunity for us each to contribute what we can. So as people who know me know, I like to debate, and sometimes I come with good facts and sometimes I don't. But I think it's up to the person with the opinion to be able to back up their own as well. So I agree that there will be some strengths and some weaknesses, but if we come together and make a Made in Canada process, I have no doubt that we will be able to overcome any obstacle.
Change in the voting system is not sexy. How are you going to engage Canadians? The economy, when you get into power, the economy, the CF18s, they're going to take up all the chatter, all the time. What are you going to do to put this first and foremost in the minds of Canadians, and how are you going to educate us?
So I agree it might not be sexy, but I've knocked on a lot of doors, and when I raise the conversation of electoral reform, it definitely piqued interest. So there is a desire for it, I assure you. The desire is greater than the people in this room. So not only do our elected officials have a role to play, we each have a role to play. And we here right now have an opportunity to change the process so that every vote counts. We can bring in a process that is effective, that is fair, that is all the great things that we need it to be. So So I assure you, based on the room, people have to standing, there's no seats, we are interested, and we have a role to play, and we will make it happen. So Justin Trudeau and the Liberals have committed to 18 months after being elected to bringing forward legislation. So you have a time, you have a date, so you can look forward to change happening. And that's why we're talking about real change. Thank you.
This is perhaps a sort of awkward question to end on. But one of the advantages of, you know, electoral reform and proportional representation is that things like, you know, the spoiler effect and stuff, where different parties that share issues don't necessarily detract from one another, is less of an issue. But so it would be great to have something like STB where we would elect all three of you. But as it stands, we currently don't. And I was wondering how you felt about what someone who was trying to vote for a fairer system, how they should approach that this election under the broken system.
Are you asking how did we get to a fairer election process?
I could have been, yeah.
Yeah. That's what I took as a question. I was once taught to answer the question I wanted to not. I like answering questions, and I think that's important to do. So I think when it comes to a point I raised earlier, we need a new prime minister, we need a new government. Any party that's at this table is committed to electoral reform, and that's how we'll get it done. So I think it's important that, you know, you vote how you need to vote to get us there. So it's a matter of, it's on you. Nobody can tell me how to vote. Do I tend to vote smart? Yes. That's partly why I support electoral reform, is because people should get to vote for people and not against people. But in this election, it might be the last time we need to do that.